If in his presence she forgot a while, grief filled his absence with its aching touch. She saw the desert of her coming days. He made in every solitary hour. She saw the desert of her coming days. Although with the vain imaginary bliss of fiery union to death door of escape, she drained of her body robed in funeral flame. She knew she must not clutch that happiness to die with him and follow, seizing his robe across our other countries, travelers glad into the sweet or terrible beyond. For those sad parents still would need her here to help the empty remnant of their day. Savitri is facing a tough situation. She is weighing all the possibilities that lie ahead of her in future. She is at a dead end of the road. She does not know where to go, what to do, what is going to happen tomorrow. While she was in the company of Satyavan, she was of course very happy. But his absence filled her heart and body and her soul. It became unbearable also. When he will be no more at all, she does not know what she is going to do, what will be her plight. If while living his absence, when he has gone to the forest for his daily work, she would constantly remember him, and with the aching touch lived a grieving life, she would not know what will happen to her after his death. That is a deadlock. That is a block. That is the dead end of her life she is seeing in front of her. It is a desert life. It is a wasteland. A desert which under the hot sun will even dissolve the shadow of a person. It is under that circumstance, under those conditions, Savitri is psychologically unsettled. So, one of the possibilities she is being in her thought, in her feelings, even possibly in her action, is to go as Sati along with Satyavan's body when it is put on the burning pyre. Although with a vain imaginary bliss, but that itself is an imagination, and the bliss of accompanying him therefore is vain. Although with the vain imaginary bliss of fiery union through death's door of escape, she dreamed of her body robed in funeral flame. She knew she must not clutch that happiness. No, that is not the way for me. Although she imagined that as a possibility, of going Satyavan. That is not my way. I cannot adopt that path. I cannot go as Sati. Why? God came and followed, seizing his robe across our other countries, travelers glad into the sweet or terrible beyond. She would not like to be one who take that journey. Why? Because those sad parents, Satyavan's father and mother, old parents, for those sad parents, still would need her here. Who take care of those poor souls? Her father-in-law is blind. He cannot move around. Her mother-in-law is pale and frail. She cannot do ordinary common household things at all. Who is going to attend to them if she goes away as Sati? Is that a good option for her? That is what she is thinking of. But then she says, those sad parents still would need her here to help the empty remnant of their day. For whatever short duration they might be living after that, they would need some physical help, some support, somebody to take care of them every day. So here, Savitri is on that basis that her parents-in-law would need her help. She is rejecting the idea of going as Sati. No, I cannot abandon this world and go as Sati. What will happen to these old people? Blind father-in-law, frail mother-in-law. What will happen to them in my absence? And therefore, she says that, no, I cannot go wearing the robe of a Sati and plunging on the fire of his body. She cannot go that. Now, there are a few important considerations here. First is the idea of going as Sati. Savitri is, of course, dismissing it because her parents-in-law would need her help. So the idea of going as Sati, she is keeping aside, she is dismissing it. But at the same time, there is the ideal behind the Satihood. There is some truth, there is some merit, there is some value, some occult relationship between the two by which the fulfillment, by going as Sati, the fulfillment of which is achieved. So there is the ideal behind the act of going as Sati. The idea of going as Sati no more now exists in the mind of Savitri. But the fact that the poet, the yogi, the social thinker is bringing this concept here in the description, it also means that it is a value. It is not there for nothing. Sati cannot be dismissed. There might have been degradation. The tradition might have got degraded in the course of time, but the ideal of Sati is very pure, very flaming, very bright, very acceptable in a deeper occult sense. And that cannot be dismissed. In fact, had it not been so, had there not been any meaning in the ideal of sati, Sri Aurobindo would not have introduced this idea at all in the poem. He values it, and therefore he is introducing that idea in the mind of Savitri. The ideal is perfect, has a truth in it, and it has to be weighed in its proper sense. Now, what is sati? Well, the physical act is the wife throws herself into the flames of the burning body of her husband. She is fearless, she has made a determination, she weighs no pros and cons. For her, there is a complete identification with her Lord, and she plunges into the flame of the burning body. That is the act of sati. Well, the deeper meaning is, the word sati itself is very weighty, has deep significance in it. Sati is a feminine of sat, or truth. One who gives himself totally to the truth in every respect, in his body, in his thoughts, in his mind, in his emotions, in his feelings, in his actions, in every respect, who commits himself to truth, he is sati. Sati is not an ideal only for women. Although the word sati is basically a feminine word. So, it is giving one's life, one's entire existence in every respect to the truth of life. That is what sati means. And Savitri sees even in this act a oneness of her soul with the soul of her husband, of Satyavan. See, Satyavan, Sati, they are really interrelated. The Sanskrit language is rich in its roots and connections. Satyavan, Savitri going as Sati, they are therefore interrelated. They are not dissimilar, indifferent ideas at all. Savitri must go as Sati. The question is whether she go as Sati by burning her body or by an occult action. These are perhaps two different things. Here, Savitri is still a human Savitri, and therefore for her, burning her body is an immediate connotation. Psychologically, she will definitely sacrifice everything of hers in an occult way and give everything of hers to her husband, Satyavan. Her being, her will, her action, her idea, her thought, her knowledge, everything will get purified in that flame. There is no doubt about it. But here she has to perform a physical act, and Savitri is keeping it aside. She is ruling out that option totally. That is an important thing. Why? Because sad old parents will still need her. She is required for that purpose. Well, again, a question might arise. Is love for her husband less than her love for her parents-in-law? She is considering her commitment towards the parents-in-law more important than towards her husband. Is that the way Savitri would look at things? That is the question. For her, definitely Satyavan is more important. And parents-in-law, the whole world, the entire creation around, would not have any value to her at all, strictly speaking, you see. But still she says here, look, these parents need me. Now it is not for the sake of these parents alone in that sense that Savitri is dismissing the idea of going as sati. She also knows that her husband loved these parents very much, very well. In that sense, serving them is fulfilling the unfulfilled desire of her husband himself, of Satyavan. Satyavan loves his parents. So Savitri is in a certain sense committed to love them because of him and not necessarily because of themselves. That is the thing behind it, you see. And that could be really one way of looking at this idea of our keeping aside the act of sati. But there are still more important considerations. If Savitri goes as sati, it would mean again that the mission of her life for which she had taken this birth would remain unfulfilled. How can that be? That is there deep in her soul. How can I abandon this world? It is not for the sake of just love of her parents-in-law to serve them, not just for the sake of fulfilling the tradition of going as sati. She has a work to do here. She was born here. She was compelled to take a mortal birth for a certain purpose. What happens to that purpose? Can she therefore accept death and go away like that? That would mean the defeat. That would mean the divine intention for which, by which she had taken birth is kept aside. The divine sanction is there. Savitri, you must go there. You must conquer death. You cannot follow death. You have to conquer death. And it is that consideration which overweighs in her mind, in her soul, in her thoughts, even in her emotions, although she is charged with love for her husband and for all that her husband loves, including his parents, all that. Those sad parents still would need her here to help the empty remnant of their day, not for their own sake, perhaps so much, but for the sake of Satyavan. He would wish her, Savitri, please stay back and attend to my parents. To fulfill that wish, he would rule out the possibility of going as sati. There is no doubt about that. Now, Savitri is talking here about her parents-in-law, that they will need her. There is another way of looking at it. It is not only just a question of those old people, but it is also the question of the oneness Savitri has with this entire creation. It is in that oneness that she accepts and does whatever has to be done. That is the important consideration here. Now we have, at every place in Savitri, wherever this question arises, the question of oneness. Savitri is facing the Supreme Lord Himself in the transcendent. Satyavan has died. She follows Yama. She defeats Yama. Behind him, she sees the transcendental Purusha. Yama transferred into the transcendental Purusha. He offers her boon after boon to Savitri. The Supreme Purusha offers her boon after boon. He offers her four boons. And one of the boons is very distinct. First, he offers her, "Accept, O music, very nice of thy notes, O stream, wide breaking of thy channel banks." And Savitri replies, "Thy peace, O Lord, a boon within to keep amid the roar and ruin of wild time, for the magnificent soul of man and earth." Her boon, her asking for the boon, her receiving the boon is for whom? For the magnificent soul of man and earth. She does not want anything for herself at all. Again, second time, Savitri says, "Thy oneness, Lord, in many approaching hearts, my sweet infinity of thy numberless souls, for man and on earth." Then for oneness with the entire creation here. And then Savitri says, "Thy energy, Lord, to seize on woman and man, to take all things and creatures in their grief and gather them into a mother's arm." That is what I want your energy for. That the grief of man and woman is removed from this creation. "Thy energy, Lord, to seize on woman and man, to take all things and creatures in the grief and gather them into a mother's arms." And finally, she says, "Thy embrace, which rend the living knot of pain." I want your embrace for what? To remove this pain. "Thy embrace, which rend the living knot of pain. Thy joy, O Lord, in which all creatures breathe. Thy magic flowing waters of deep love. Thy sweetness give to me for earth and men." She is insistent upon that. She does not want anything for herself. Whatever she wants, even from the Supreme, is not for herself, not even for Satyavan, but for earth and men. That is her demand. And therefore, when she says, "Those sad parents still would need her ear to help the empty remnants of their day. It is for earth and men. This is a metaphorical way of putting this entire creation, earth and men, in terms of those sad parents. Sad parents symbolize, indicate, personify, so to say, this entire creation, this mortal creation, men and earth. And it is for them, whatever she wants, it is for them she wants. Therefore, it is because of that she throws away the idea of going as Sati. Savitri would not go as Sati for that particular reason. It is for this creation. That is an admission. That is the purpose for which she had taken this birth. And how can she go away from this creation? Now, it is in that context we have to see the meaning of Sati and understand its implications. As I said earlier, the idea of Sati is very ancient. It is present even in the Vedas, certainly present in the Puranas, present in the Mahabharata, present even in the Ramayana, the idea of Sati. See, in the Ramayana, Indrajit, the son of Ravana, when he was killed by Lakshman, then his wife Sulochana went as Sati. That was the oneness. There was something great even in those asuras. She went as Sati, Indrajit's wife. In Mahabharata, we of course had the famous story of Pandu and Madri. When Pandu, the father of the Pandavas, he died, it is Madri who went as Sati. Pandu had two wives, Kunti and Madri. Madri went as Sati. Kunti stayed back to take care of her children, five Pandavas, who were received by her as gifts from five gods. So, the heavenly powers had taken a human birth in the form of Pandavas. And those gods, assuming the human birth, had to fight against the Asuric forces which were raging in the world at the time. So the Mahabharata war is actually the war between the right and the wrong. And the right could triumph because the gods themselves had taken the human birth. And of course, more importantly, the Lord Himself, Krishna Himself, was on their side. Madri had gone as Sati. So there is a deeper tradition of Sati. Had that not been the meaning and content of Sati, Srivindu would not have introduced this idea of Sati in the epic at this particular stage. As I said earlier, the tale of Savitri, Radha Satyavan and Savitri, is a Vedic tale. And if the tale had that Vedic significance, it is sort of natural that that is also incorporated in the epic Savitri, by the yogis here, because it has a true content in it. Savitri is dismissing here the idea of going as sati because she has a work to do. The oneness with this creation is what will hold her back to this creation. She would not go away from this creation for that particular reason. Madhuri could go, Sulochana could go, others could go for various reasons, but Savitri cannot go. It will be a failure of her taking a birth here.